This is the last part of a series on k-means clustering. In this video, we will look at how to determine the optimal number of clusters in k-means clustering. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated by AI, text-to-speech. In k-means clustering, determining the appropriate number of clusters is very important. As you saw in the previous video, in the case of two-dimensional data, the exact number of clusters could be easily confirmed with the naked eye. However, in the case of high-dimensional data, it is not easy to know. Therefore, an algorithm for this is needed. Popular algorithms include the elbow method and the silhouette method. In this video, we will analyze these algorithms and implement them with code. First, let's look at the elbow method. It's very simple. The elbow method is a graphical method to find the optimal number of clusters, K. Perform k-means by varying k-value and measure the errors. In the example below, if you set k small at first and gradually increase k, the error will gradually become smaller. At first, the error decreases quickly, but later the error decreases slowly. In the error graph, the point where the graph forms an elbow is likely to be the optimal k-value. Let's look at the code and results. Generate training data. You can generate data consisting of 3 or 4 clusters. First, we will generate data consisting of 3 clusters. Let's write a function to color code and visualize training data and clusters. We then train the k-means model by changing k from 2 to 6. Then we measure the error and store it in a list. We looked at the concept of errors for unsupervised learning in the first video. Color code and visualize the training data points and their clusters. And we observe the change in error with the change in k. The results are as follows. When k is 2, the data is clustered into 2 groups like this. The error for this clustering is this much. When k is 3, the data is clustered into 3 groups like this. This clustering looks good. The error for this clustering is this much. When k is 4, the data is clustered into 4 groups like this. And the error for this clustering is this much. As k increases, we can see that the error changes as follows. This is the point where the graph forms an elbow. This point is likely to be the optimal k value. Therefore, it makes sense to cluster this data into 3 groups. Next, let's apply the elbow method to data consisting of 4 clusters. When k is 2, the data is clustered into 2 groups like this. The error for this clustering is this much. When k is 3, the data is clustered into 3 groups like this. The error for this clustering is this much. When k is 4, the data is clustered into 4 groups like this. This clustering looks good. The error for this clustering is this much. In this case, the k value at the elbow point is 4. Therefore, it makes sense to cluster this data into 4 groups. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. The optimal number of clusters for this data is 3. Let's apply this to data consisting of 4 clusters. The results are as follows. The optimal K for this data is 4. Next, let's look at the silhouette method. The silhouette method is a way to measure clustering performance and can be used to determine the optimal number of clusters. It uses a silhouette coefficient, which combines both cohesion and separation. Cohesion is a measure of how closely the data points in a cluster are related to each other. Separation is a measure of how different or separated one cluster with another cluster. The higher the silhouette coefficient, the better the clustering performance. Let's look at how to calculate the silhouette coefficient through an example below. Blue data points belong to cluster 1, and red data points belong to cluster 2. Calculate the cohesion for a data point x1. Cohesion is the average distance between x1 and other data points in the same cluster. Next, we calculate the separation for x1. Separation is the average distance between x1 and the data points in the nearest cluster. Let's call the cohesion A, and let the separation be B. This example shows good clustering. The separation is large compared to cohesion. If B is greater than A, A over B will be smaller. If you want to make this larger for good clustering, you can measure 1 minus A over B. This time, we will look at the case where clustering is incorrect. In this case, the separation is small compared to the cohesion. If B is greater than A, then A over B becomes larger, and 1 minus A over B becomes smaller compared to those of the left. We then see that we can use 1 minus A over B as a performance measure for clustering. Now let's define the silhouette coefficient using cohesion and separation. If B is greater than A, we define the silhouette coefficient for x1 as 1 minus A over B. If B and A are equal, the silhouette coefficient is 0. If B is less than A, we define the silhouette coefficient as A over B minus 1. This allows the silhouette coefficient to be between 0 and 1. The closer the silhouette coefficient is to 1, the better the clustering performance is. And the closer it is to 0, the worse the clustering performance is. Alternatively, the silhouette coefficient can be defined as follows. Similar to the case above, but using the larger of cohesion and separation as the denominator. This makes the silhouette coefficient a value between minus 1 and plus 1. The denominator is to normalize B minus A. In this example, we calculated the silhouette coefficient for a data point x1. Silhouette coefficients are calculated for all data points, and their average is calculated and used as the silhouette score. The larger the silhouette score, the better the clustering performance. Next, let's write a code to calculate the silhouette score. We will use scikit-learn's k-means model and use the Euclidean distances class for distance calculation. Generate data in a k-means model, then fit the model to the data. Estimate the cluster number of each data point, and find the coordinates of the centroids. We then find the data points belonging to each cluster. Next, we calculate cohesion and separation for all data points. Calculate the distance between the data point xi and other data points in the same cluster. And then calculate the average of the distances. When calculating the average, xi itself is excluded. Now calculate the separation. First, find the nearest cluster to the data point xi. Calculate the distances between the data point xi and the centroid of all clusters. And find the nearest cluster. The cluster to which xi belongs is excluded. Calculate the distances between the data point xi and all data points belonging to the nearest cluster. And if you calculate the average of these distances, this is the separation. Next, we calculate the silhouette coefficient using this formula. Accumulate the silhouette coefficient for all data points. At the end of the for loop, we calculate the average of the silhouette coefficients. This is the silhouette score. Next, let's calculate this using scikit-learn's silhouette score class. Calculate the silhouette score using the data x and cluster numbers. The distance metric used is Euclidean. Let's check the results. Both results are the same, 0.6478. Our computational results and scikit-learn's results are in good agreement. Let's run this code. The results are as follows, and both results are identical. Lastly, let's write a code to determine the optimal k using the silhouette score. This time, we will use scikit-learn's silhouette samples class. This calculates the silhouette coefficient for every data point. Train the k-means model by varying k from 2 to 5. At each iteration, we compute the silhouette coefficients for all data points. And if we calculate the average of the silhouette coefficients, this is the silhouette score. Visualize the data points and their clusters. Finally, we visualize the silhouette coefficients of the data points belonging to each cluster. I'll skip the explanation of this code here and discuss the silhouette plot by looking at the results on the next page. I reference this resource for silhouette plots. The clustering results when k is 2 are like this. The data is clustered into two groups like this. The silhouette plots are as follows. The silhouette coefficients of each data for each cluster are represented as bar graphs. The silhouette coefficients of the data points belonging to cluster 0 are like this. The size of the silhouette coefficient of one data point is this much. And the size of that of another data point is this much. The smaller silhouette coefficients are shown below, and the larger ones are shown above. In other words, the silhouette coefficients are sorted in ascending order. The silhouette coefficients of the data points belonging to cluster 1 are shown in green. You can see that the silhouette coefficients of cluster 0 are smaller than those of cluster 1. Additionally, the silhouette plot of cluster 0 has a larger thickness. that is, cluster 0 contains more data points. The silhouette score, which is the overall average of the silhouette coefficients, looks like this. Most of the silhouette coefficients in cluster 0 are smaller than the silhouette score. This is not a good thing. This silhouette plot can be used to determine the optimal K. We combine several factors to determine the optimal K. The first is to check whether the silhouette plots of all clusters exceed the average silhouette score. If so, this K could be a good candidate for being optimal. K, 2, 4, or 5 are unlikely candidates because these plots are smaller than the average. The second is to check if there is a large variation in the size of the silhouette plots. If so, this K is likely not optimal. The third is to check whether the thickness of the silhouette plot is uniform. If so, this K is likely to be optimal. Of these results, K equal to 3 is the best. Most silhouette plots have larger than average silhouette score and small deviation. And the thickness of the silhouette plot is also uniform. Moreover, the average silhouette score is also the highest at 0.6515. Therefore, it is recommended to cluster this data into 3 groups. Although the elbow method and silhouette method are not perfect, they can be of great help in determining the optimal K. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. So far, we have looked at K-means clustering through a total of 4 videos.